Welcome to my channel, Fat Dandelions. My name is Melinda Lee. This is the last print paper pad. It's called the best time of the year. This I call it the red version because all the colors I've already mentioned is the pink one, the golden one, the blue version, and this is the red version. And I will show you all the different. They show you the samples what's in the printed paper here inside. And it says here on the bottom, it says, you hardly can see it, but I will read it for you. Design pad, 24 sheets with 24 designs, 230 GSM. So let's start. This is knitted wear in some kind of pattern, but it's hardly, you can see it. These kind of paper, I really don't like. I love knitted wear printed paper, but this is so dark and you hardly can see it. I tend to use this kind of paper that is fuzzy and not very clear. I use it more as a background paper. So if you're making a card or a snail mail, I cut this paper in kind of size. So if I make a card, I cut it like this, and then here I make a fold to fold it with my guillotine and not cut it, of course. Here I will cut the horizontal line. I fold it and then I'll put a better picture or illustration here. A few centimeters shorter on each side. That's on the vertical side and on the horizontal side. So you create like a layer on a layer. So that's what I do. So you don't waste this kind of paper, but you can still use it. So that's how I use these kinds of paper that are not pretty enough. It's still pretty. It's you can see there's a knitwear line. If you watch good, it's poinsettias here or poinsettias. Here there's this line and there there's poinsettias, but in between you can clearly see that's other knitted wear print. Next page is plaid with horizontal and vertical gold foiled lines. Next is, I don't know what kind of plant it is, but I'll show you up close and personal like that. I don't know, I know these berries, but I don't know the name anymore. Because my children, when they were like babies, when they are after 1 year, they can drink that kind of syrup. To it's a fruit syrup, they call it, because they need nutrients. And this has a lot of chock full of vitamins and antioxidant and something like that. So I know the name in Dutch. We call it rozenbottel, but I don't know how to call it in English. Because I didn't know this kind of berries would be there. This is, I believe, holly. Yeah, I believe it's holly. Wait. Oh, it's intertwined. Holly and mistletoe and pine cones all nested in each other in a print. Beautiful advent calendar numbers. And it goes up to 25. How's that possible? Wait. Oh, 5 by 5. Okay. Because some of these advent calendars goes up to 24. So this is the one with up to 25. Then you got a beautiful printed paper with mistletoes, stars, aniseed, poinsettias. Candy cane, that's the word, candy cane. Ugh. The previous paper pad, I forgot the word, it's candy cane. Then you got plaid again. It's a green background with small golden foil dots. I can show it to you in close up. Next page is, let me see, page with only the holly. Yeah, it's the holly. And then you have a page with songs, Christmas songs. but a little bit of twist. It says "All I Want for Christmas," and then it says "It's me." So it actually is the me part. It's not supposed to be in there. It says here "Christmas wishes, a very Merry Christmas to you." This one, it says "The best time of the year. My favorite color is Christmas lights." I don't think it's Christmas lights. I believe it's red. And this one says, "It's the season to be jolly. Baby, it's cold outside." This one says, "Have a holly jolly Christmas." And the bottom is, "Have yourself a merry little Christmas." This one is the same print as the previous one. It was green background with gold foiled dots, but this one has red background with no gold foil dots, but dots. I'll show it up for you in close-up. And then this beautiful page is a white background, but you see all the spruces and pine cones and poinsettias and the berries and mistletoes. Oh wait, is that berries? Yeah, rose bottle in Dutch. Plaid again. Another print with holly. I'll show it up close like that. Oops. Then a beautiful page, a beautiful illustration. Sadly, these are not die-cutted for you, pre-die-cutted. You have to cut it yourself with a pair of scissors. So that's a lot of fun, especially the stars. How are you going to do that? Well, the reason is you cut all the big illustrations out. And if you're close enough here with the stars, you can use the punches. I don't have one in sight. But it's smaller than this one. Wait, I can grab it. Wait, can I still grab one? I'm going to grab one. Wait for it. So you have to find, you'll find punches like these, but this one you have to find one that is a bigger circle than this one, of course, otherwise you cannot, you can still use for the smaller stars, this one, but not for the bigger stars. But if you find a puncher, but with a bigger circle to cut out, you can cut the stars out neatly, and you don't have to cut it with your scissors, because that's tedious to do every single star. But the bigger ones you can cut easily with your scissors. Okay, that's the next one. Plaid again. This one is red background with, I thought it was dots, but it's not dots, it's Christmas trees. Yeah. Then you've got a print that has, let me see, yeah, that's holly and pine cones. Is there something else in between? No, only those. Okay, next one is the same as the one with the red background, but this is a green background with small, tiny Christmas trees. Then you get all the cards that you can cut out. These are tags, but sadly they have not done punched holes in it. You have to cut, sadly, the cards yourself with scissors and punch any other punches you have with small holes. You can punch the holes in there and put a string in there, or just glue the whole card onto the present or gift. And you put a beautiful, beautiful bow on top. So you can do that. I have a green background with a lot of different kinds of sizes of light blue or light green circles. But if you stand from afar, it looks like snow. We have this is a green background with gold foiled circles. We have, No, it almost resembles the first page, but the first page had poinsettias, but this one has Christmas trees. Oh, this has poinsettias too. So you got here the poinsettias, Christmas tree, poinsettias, Christmas tree, poinsettias, and Christmas tree lines, horizontal lines. Okay. Then you got cards again. You have to cut it yourself with scissors if you don't have a bigger puncher to cut these. Yeah, you have to do it manually with your scissors. I am unfortunate. I don't have a bigger puncher for this. But I thought by myself, maybe I can use this one. But sadly, this one only cuts out bigger circles. And the disadvantage is... is there? Yeah, you can't use it on small circles. I have a tool for smaller circles, but that tool does what it does is it has a disadvantage. That tool has a needle. You have to put the needle in the center, and then with the tool you can go around it and it cuts perfectly a circle out, but you still have that hole in your beautiful circular piece. So that's a no-go. So sadly, you have to do it with scissors then. Okay, that's the last page. So, thank you for watching. And I hope you enjoyed this. Me showing, revealing the prints of the best time of the year. And of course, I could have shown you only this. But it wouldn't be fun if I only showed you up close the samples. So, I thought to myself, better show you all of it. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye, everyone.